everyone. It's wonderful to see you for this first session for the mentorship program, which is organized by the ACL. And this is a program that we started inspired by the mentorship sessions taking place at the ACL conferences and realizing that there is a lot of interest for that. And there is also limitation in the sense that they were taking place only during conferences. There is no reason for that to stay that way. And that's why the reason we started this program. This is an effort that we started together with Mohit Bansal, Vinod Pratakaran, Luis Jingjin, Ash Kazemi, and Lisa Bauer. And really the goal is to get together with all of you, with students who are interested in NLP from all over the world, and share some of the things that we've learned along the way, see what kind of questions you have, and of course, just learn from each other. For today, the plan is to start with some introductions. I'm joined here today by two other mentors, Saif Mohammad from the National Research Council in Canada, and Soujanya Poria from the Singapore University of Technology and Design. And so we'll start with some introductions, just telling briefly about ourselves, and then we'll share how we go about choosing an NLP project, and also how we participate in conversations with students or interns about choosing an NLP project. And the goal is to give those initial introductions brief, so that we can spend most of the time addressing questions from you. So I would like to encourage you to ask your questions in chat. And unfortunately, because we have such a large group, which again is amazing to see all this interest, we are not able to do introductions from everyone, but we will be taking questions from whoever has them. So please write your questions in chat. And we can also try to do questions live if you wanted to raise your hand when we get to that part. Also, we are recording the first part, so when the mentors will be introducing themselves and talking about how they go about choosing an NLP project, we'll record that part, and we'll stop the recording when we get to the question part, so you feel as comfortable as you can asking your questions. All right, so with that, I'll invite Saif. If you want to introduce yourself and talk briefly about how you go about choosing NLP projects.
Sure. Thank you, Radha. And thank you for the mentorship team for inviting me and for doing this event. I think this is fantastic. And thank you all for coming and joining us here. So my name is Saif Mohammad. I'm a senior research scientist at the National Research Council Canada. I did my PhD at the University of Toronto. And one of the things common both at that university and at NRC is that I've been lucky to get a lot of freedom about what research projects I want to work on. So that was fantastic, but that might not always be the case. And sometimes you have to find projects within the scope of the funding scheme given to you. But I'm going to be bringing this sort of perspective where you have complete choice and you can work on things that you're excited about, right? So I've largely worked on emotions and language, but that's just part of my introduction. When it comes to picking topics, I think this is quite interesting. At the University of Toronto, one of the things people would tell me is that, as a new PhD student, it's daunting to find a PhD topic or a research topic. On the other hand, people would also remind me that this is such an opportunity, because where else will you get the chance you can work on something for a prolonged period of time, something that you are excited about. So I think we should remember both sides of that, or at least the positive side. And when I came to NRC again, it was somewhat interesting where people said, hey, we picked you to do good research, and this is not like a company. We don't want you to work on something safe or simple or easy. Work on something that is risky and tricky and something that will have more impact and things like that. So I was just really lucky to have that kind of environment. So in terms of how to pick a project, one of the things people say is that how picking a topic is research by itself, because you have to, you don't just pick a topic, it's not a serial process that you go in line, but a circular sort of process where you sort of bootstrap over things. So you pick up sort of a direction of interest, you read relevant literature, you do some work, and that helps you get lots of ideas, see what are the, you know, what's a promising direction to work on. And then you go back and hone your original directions further on. Sometimes you might dramatically change it even. And when it comes to, you know, a key part is this sort of read the literature. And of course, that involves not just NLP literature, but also other fields. But you can also get your ideas from other places like industry. For example, what does industry really care for? You can also look at the people who are impacted by the technology. What do they want? So there are a number of audiences here that you can, from whom you can get ideas about what you should work on. So that said, once you've got some sort of ideas, a key question is how do you assess a topic or question? And for me, I think the single most important thing is how compelling is this research question? So first of all, from my own perspective, am I excited about this project? Would I be get up in the morning and be like, yes, I want to work on this? I think that's super important. I also like to think a little bit about, are others excited? Will others be excited about this project if I tell them about it? Now, I'm not usually in the space of everybody is excited about this and working on this and I want to work on that. That's different. You can choose to work on that or not do that. I'm usually on the work on stuff that not everybody's working on. I prefer to work on stuff that is a little more different. What I'm telling is that when I pick up a topic and I tell other people, how excited will they be? I think that's a interesting sort of gauge of things as well, because sometimes we can be drawn into certain topics without realizing maybe it's not the greatest or something like that. However, sometimes you are confident and others might not be, and so don't let that stop you. If you know that this topic is of great value, go for it, right? So a key question is how compelling is it? How much impact will this have? What will have more impact amongst the many topics you might have? How useful will this be to others? I like to think of that as well. It's nice to make things that other people find useful, then more people will follow your work. It's good to think about what values are being promoted by this work. Are you trying to make the world a better place? Helping the marginalized people? Are you working on just for the sake of science, for a sense of discovery? Are you trying to make things easier and efficiency? It's not a bad idea to think about what exactly, what values your research, your labor is supporting if you work on that topic. And last but not least, I also would say it's good to think about what research skills will this topic help you develop? Because you're still learning and we are always learning. And I think working at NLP or research in general is a great place because you can see, oh, I'm interested in that, a little bit of psychology, and will this project help me get some skills from there? Or cognitive science or machine learning or linguistics and things like that. So you can assess topics that way too. All right, I think that's my spiel.
Thank you, Saif. That's great. So Soujanya, do you want to go next?
Sure. Okay, first of all, a great initiative. So thanks very much, ACL, for that. And thanks everyone for joining. Okay, so I'm Soujanya Poria. So I live in Singapore and a faculty at Singapore University of Technology and Design. And I work in dialogue systems, common sense reasoning, sentiment analysis. These are my topics. So back to the topic. So when I started my PhD, I mean, Saif has actually covered most of it. I have nothing much new to say. But when I started my PhD, what I mostly thought about, is you choose a topic of sentiment analysis and see what is happening and what more to do. So I read one such paper in 2012, which is about multimodal sentiment analysis, which is actually by Rada. And it actually, it actually gave me, draws my interest about this research field. This was a very new research field and a lot to do, it's a developing area. So yeah, so there you go. So you have to read a lot, about the different topics, not just only a single topic, different topics. Only then you will understand that how much potential there is for a good research career. Now, there are some differences, like you choose a PhD topic, but if you see that in 4 years of span, you would not be able to publish, you would not be able to make a good coherent story that can give you recognition and a thorough, some continuous publications that can really create a new field or show a new direction, a continuous buildup of the whole topic. So that is very important in my opinion. Like when I started my PhD, it was my main goal that I will choose a topic which is of course impactful, which should be which should draw interest of others. But as I said, that you have to make sure that you will find that this topic should be very broad, that you can publish continuous you can publish continuously. And and also second thing is that always discuss before you select your PhD topic, always discuss with many other researchers, like that can be your colleagues, your faculty supervisor, or even supervisor from other departments. That is very important, so that you can find that whether your topic is multidisciplinary or whether there is enough impact that you can make. So yeah, so but these are the things I think. And rest of it Saif already covered. Yeah.
All right, well, thank you. And my name I should have introduced at the beginning. I'm Radha Mihalcea. I'm a professor at the University of Michigan. And in terms of how I go about choosing an NLP project, I usually try to follow my interests. If I'm not interested very much in a project, I see I'm dragging things, I'm not really excited about meetings. So I very seldomly experience that because I usually just go with projects that really interest me. So I think that's a key factor in choosing an NLP project. Another dimension that I carefully consider is impact of a problem. And that's another way to choose project. So if you see a problem around you that you think it will make a huge difference if somebody would address that, then you can think around that, what would be some NLP projects that would make a difference in that problem and will be impactful for the people who are affected by that particular problem or situations that are affected by that problem. So that's another criterion. And of course, it's having ideas. So I may be super excited about a potential problem and want really to help and do something, or maybe I'm super interested in another potential project, but I have zero ideas. So there is really no reason to rush into that. I'll probably just wait for when I'll get some good ideas, or together with collaborators, we'll get some good ideas. So those will be the three main things that I consider. So my own interest, which may sound selfish, but I think it's really important for you to be really interested in what you are doing, the impact of the problem you're addressing, and then having ideas. Now, there are also other factors to consider. One is bandwidth. And really, depending on where you are in your career, that may be a big factor, right? So you want to carefully think about that, like how much time you would have to devote and whether you can really address that project or not. Another, which is also very important, is what kind of collaborators you need. I'm generally very excited about interdisciplinary projects. And so even if I come with the expertise in NLP, there might be other angles that need to be addressed by by others from other disciplines. And so that's something else to consider. Even within NLP, so not even talking about multiple disciplines, having the right collaborators can make a huge difference. So that's something else to consider for the project you are thinking about. Do you need any collaborators? What kind of collaborators do you need? And can you, in fact, get in touch with such collaborators? And that's also the topic of one of the future mentorship sessions, how to do networking, how to find collaborators. And then the other thing, which may sound counterintuitive when I'll say it, but really it's a factor for how I go about choosing project, is how busy that space is. I think the natural tendency is to go to busy places, like say people work now on language model, and that should be my next project. I usually go the other way. And not because I do it, I think it's a healthier, better way to go about things. Going to problems that are very busy spaces with a lot of people working on it means that it will be harder to make a difference, means that maybe harder to publish. You may end up with harsher reviewers because a lot of people work on that. A lot of people consider themselves experts. And just generally, it's more difficult to make a dent in such problems where, you know, half of the discipline is working on that. I'm exaggerating, of course. So usually when I see a problem where there are lots of people working on it, I go elsewhere. That's of course something for you to consider, what's your the personal decision there. But to me is a factor that I consider in choosing a project. And now when it's about choosing a project together with a student, that of course there are other factors that will come into play. The student interest, of course, the background, are they the right time to address that project? Their bandwidth, will they have the time to address the project? So that's when I, as a professor, work together with the student and we think about the next project. Those are additional factors in aside from what I've said so far. All right, so with that, I think we've all done introductions and talking briefly about how we go about projects, so we can move on to the questions.